Hi everyone and welcome back. So we were able to run the unit test cases. In the last video we created a auth middleware, right? So this auth middleware is just validating the request, validating the token through another service, and that service is doing nothing but returning true and false. Okay, so if it is true, that means okay, yes, you can go ahead and access your controller or particular endpoint. Otherwise, we are sending unauthorized. Okay, and we created a test service for this. Inside this, you can see there is a test service and auth service we have created where we had the validate method. Now, unit tests are fine. I'm inside a container and I'm able to run npm run test unit and my all test cases are passing. So that is about unit test. Now, what about the integration tests? So you can see currently we have these all endpoints exposed. These all endpoints are API v1, user, users, users by ID, users get, all these endpoints are there. And we have to test these with the help of end-to-end test cases. So what you need to do, you go to this E2E folder, test folder, E2E, and you can create the end-to-end test cases. So let's say first we'll create for Swagger, swagger.e2e.spec.ts. I think this is how we are naming the files, e2e-spec.spec. Otherwise, while running these end-to-end test cases, these will not be able to come into the regex criteria, because we are looking for we are looking inside test folder all the files which are matching with this e2e-spec.ts. okay, now Swagger spec. So how we are creating the end-to-end test? So we are using Supertest for writing the test cases in the Nest.js. okay, we are using Supertest and it's going to be the same describe it block. First we have to get the app module, so we will get the app module from our definition, because now we have to start the application and then run the test. So if I simply write the test case for the Swagger, then it will be, I will just copy it from template. It is simple, like this is also available in the Nest.js documentation. What we are doing is simply we are getting the app module, we are initializing the Nest.js application. And how we are getting the application? Using create testing module and dot compile. Here we are creating the application and then doing dot init. So this is the application initialization step. Okay, after this you can write your test cases, API test cases. We are going to get the HTTP server, going to hit the endpoint, API v1 health, and we are going to check that we are getting the status code 200, getting the appropriate request response body and all these things. So first let's import these assertions and all. Spect chai, okay. So go to the top. This we don't need. And we are getting expect from chai. And this testing module we already have. Let me just see why this describe block is creating a problem. Okay, we need to just install all these two modules. We need to install npm install type chest and type mocha. We have to add type mocha. So we are already inside a container. What we can do is simply go to the starter node. We are inside a container and do this. So we should be able to resolve the describe for each, before each, after each, all these things. So if you just see the structure of this end-to-end test case, we got the app module. We are importing the app module, compiling it, and then initializing it. That's it. Now you can do, you can test your APIs. So what our APIs are, API v1, API v1 health, right? API, this is expecting 404 because API is not there. This is API v1 health, so it should return 200 as a status code. Similarly, we can write our other e2e test cases also. Those e2e test cases will be like users.e2espec.ts. users.a2espec.ts. So what we can do is we can just copy this Swagger one, and we just need to change our endpoints, right? For user, we have all these get user, create user, get all user, all these endpoints are there. And if you remember correctly, we have one more thing is for the API V1 routes, there is a middleware already sitting. Okay, so we have to actually mock the auth middleware so that we should be able to pass through this. Okay, but one thing is you have to provide the authorization token. This is the auth middleware we have. What this auth middleware is saying is you should at least have authorization, and then we can mock this service. We can mock the auth service validate method, which will always return true, so that we can actually go to our controller. So how we can do this? We can actually use the same mechanism which we have done in the last video, is like override provider, right? If we go to users.e2espec.ts, this is where we are compiling. So before doing that, we can actually override a particular service. So here, override auth service, and there is a method validate. Okay, so we are going to override a particular method here. So we have validate from auth service, that should always return true. Now, whatever the implementation inside it, you might have written a lot of code inside it, we don't need to worry about it. We are just overriding this validate method of auth service, okay, which is returning us as a true. And now you can freely go ahead and access your endpoint, because this auth middleware, now we have done the mocking. We'll import this auth middleware. So this is fine. Now we can start accessing our endpoints. So like this is API V1 user. What I'm saying is, whenever I'm hitting API V1 users, then I should get status code 200, response type is application JSON, all these things. You can add assertions. You can actually assign it to an object, right? And then like const response, you can convert it into async await. Const response, and then you can write your assertions like response.status should be equal to this and equal to that. So here response.status is 200. That is what I'm looking for. Here it will be await, okay, otherwise it will be a promise. So response.status 200. Similarly, you can write all your methods, all your endpoints. I will just resolve these two. Similarly, you can actually create user, get user, get all. So what I will do is, I will finish this and we will run npm run test, which will run unit test and integration test. And then we will also get the coverage out of it. Okay, let's do that in the next video. Thanks everyone.